Leviticus chapter 19, verse 1 to 3. And the Lord also said to Moses, give the following instructions to the entire community of Israel. You must be holy because I am the Lord your God am holy. Each of you must show great respect for your mother and father, and you must always observe my Sabbath days of rest. I am the Lord your God. And I think it's so fascinating that each time God would speak over his people throughout the course of the Old Testament pertaining to the Ten Commandments, he always repeats similar patterns. And the first thing that caught my attention is this, that he always declares who he is first. He always says, I am the Lord your God. Here's why that's significant, because this obedience that he's asking of us does not come from a place of obligation, but it comes from a space of identity. It comes not from doing, but from being. Because when we understand who God is, then we find our purpose and our being and our significance and our own identity in who he is. So when he says that, I am the Lord your God, he's saying that you are my people. When he is saying that I'm your husband, that means we are his bride. When he's saying that he is the head, then we are his body. When he's saying that he is the father, then we are his household. When he's saying that, you know, he is the Holy Spirit, he is the Spirit of the living God, then we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So there's this idea of being communicated over and over again that our obedience to the commandments of God, this idea of rest, does not come from strife, but it comes from a state of being. This is who we are. This is our identity in God. And so in this particular passage in the book of Leviticus, I found it very fascinating that God connects Sabbath with honoring our father and mother. And in this one, it's broken down even more. How do we practice honoring? By showing great respect. And we've been learning that the idea of Sabbath or resting is living the life that God intended for us to live. And that is in intimacy with him and in intimacy with others. And the practical application of that is the culture of honor that we want to build. And the practicality broken down even in honoring our authority here is showing great respect to our mother and father. And what that means is I will honor what their opinions are. And how many of you don't always agree with the opinions or the thoughts or the actions or decisions of those who are leading you or those who have been placed as an authority over your life? We don't always agree, but however, we are asked by God to live out this idea of showing great respect, that I will value your opinion. I don't have to agree with you, but I will listen to what you have to say, that I will consider what you have to say. Because sometimes when people give an opinion, we already shut them down immediately. Because we feel like, you're wrong. And when we do that, this is not respecting another person's opinion. I think it's very fascinating that we live in a country that believes in the freedom of speech, but it is only free when it's our opinion. It's only free when it's our speech or something that aligns with our thoughts. And I think that needs to shift, because if we are going to learn to respect authority and respect one another, then we need to learn to value each other's opinion. And in the book of Proverbs chapter 13, verse 1, the Bible says, a wise son heeds and accepts and is the result of his father's discipline and instruction, but a scoffer does not listen to reprimand and does not learn from his errors. So there's this idea of learning as a mean of honoring also, that a son will listen, will heed, not only heed, but accepts his father's discipline and instruction. How many of us, when our covering speaks over us or give us a specific discipline or instruction, our main tendency is to say, why do I have to do that? And if you catch yourself feeling that way, maybe you need to ask, what is God my conversation concerning authority? The description of a wise son is somebody who heeds and accepts, but a scoffer does not listen and does not learn. And I think this is something that we need to arm as a mindset as those who belong to Christ Jesus. So let's practice respecting and listening.